Do you find the usual keyboards too large? Are your roommates asking you to clickety-clack some more with your mechanical keyboard? If so, I have just the right keyboard for you. Some may call it Supercoder 2000XS. Some are saying it's still too big. Some are saying, what's the point? Let me introduce the all-new keyboard designed especially for hackers and programmers. The BinKeep. Based on Arduino compatible microcontroller, user can configure this keyboard to their own liking. The PCB sandwich between Arduino and the buttons was made by the PCBWay.com, the sponsor of this video. PCBWay.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who offers PCBs starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 two-layer 100x100mm PCBs. They are a great PCB manufacturer for all your prototyping and low-volume production needs. Now they even offer 3D printing and CNC milling services. Go check out PCBWay.com. This is BinKeep, binary keyboard with only two buttons, 0 and 1. After all, deep down, everything that computers handle is made out of ones and zeros. Take out the ASCII table and start writing. One character at no, one bit at a time. Each character takes 8 presses and for maximal annoyance I made this first prototype with Cherry MX Blue switches. Clickety-clack to you too. When creating large keyboards, one would create a matrix out of buttons with some diodes and a scanning code to make it work. That's another thing that makes full-size keyboards more complicated than they need to be. With simple and effective keyboards like this, buttons can be connected directly to individual GPIO pins with appropriate pull-ups if one doesn't want to use the internal pull-up resistors of the microcontroller. Same is true for the backlight LEDs. Each LED is controlled by an individual GPIO pin. The resistor for the LEDs should be selected based on microcontroller's voltage and LED's voltage drop. There is no need for external LED controller or addressable LEDs. When using Arduino Compatible Pro Micro Development Board as brains for this keyboard, soldering is easy and bill of materials is short and simple. This is one of the easiest keeps one could build and config. This is super portable thanks to its size and most importantly, this is almost as usable as any other keyboard. Build yourself one of these using Cherry MX Blue or Green switches and you will soon get feedback on your late night writing sessions from your roommates. Let's take a closer look at the PCB and the design in general. There are 7 components or modules to be soldered on this board. 2 Cherry MX switches that have 3mm LEDs in them. 2 pull-up resistors, one for each switch. 2 resistors, one for each LED inside the switches. And lastly, on opposite side, Arduino compatible Pro Micro, which is based on USB-enabled 18Mega32U4. Components were selected based on what I already had and what were easy to use. The switches were removed from keyboard someone sold me for next to nothing. They had the 3mm LEDs in them. Arduino Pro Micro is a cheap, compact USB-enabled microcontroller board, and Cherry MX switch can be placed between its pin rows on the opposite side of the PCB without any problems. The first design mistake was evident when I soldered the first prototype. I didn't have these switches when I was designing the PCB and I didn't leave enough clearance between the switches. I had to sand the bottom corners of these keycaps so they wouldn't push against each other. I will update the design files to increase the distance a little bit. The second design mistake was the GPIO pins I used for the switches and LEDs. I don't use these 18Mega32U4 based boards very often and I had already forgotten that the pin change interrupt can't be used with all of the GPIOs in this chip. Unfortunately, one of the buttons is connected to a pin that doesn't support interrupts. It's not a big deal. I just had to use polling instead of interrupts. Usually we use interrupts if possible to make firmware as efficient as possible, saving processing time and reducing delays. Neither of these are critical in this application, so I am happy to use the polling in the loop. The basic functionality was simple to implement. Each button press will set one bit of byte to a 0 or 1, starting from the most significant bit. When all 8 bits has been set, Arduino sends a key press and key release corresponding to the character made by those 8 bits. If pause between button presses exceeds the set timeout threshold, previous bits will be discarded and next press will start a new byte. This was a fun, kinda nostalgic project. I remember seeing pictures of binary keyboards when I was a kid. Some were edited photos, some were non-functional but real keyboards made out of full-size keyboards, and surely someone had made a working one as well. The difference of this being a binary keyboard or macro keyboard is in the firmware. This can be converted into a more usable macro keyboard in moments by writing a new sketch. Some may prefer that kind of functionality over this low-level writing device. Do you have any weird keyboard projects? Share them with others in the comment section. Thanks. Bye.